Fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests, I'm very happy to be with you tonight, talking with you. Today I'd like to talk about beliefs and how important our beliefs are towards creating the reality that we want to create in the world. Now, the best example of how changing my beliefs changed my own life are in my luck with the ladies. I was always a quiet kid in high school, a nerdy guy that went to MIT, engineer mind, who never really had much experience with girls. This all came to a head about 3 years ago. I was down at a bar, third floor cafe in Koreatown in New York City. And there I was at a friend's birthday party. Sitting down, I started chatting with a nice girl. She was cute. We hit it off. I could tell that she really liked me. There I was, on this plush red couch, the music bumping in the background, sipping out of our fruity little drinks. She was sitting next to me on the couch, no more than 6 inches away from me. I could tell that she liked me, and I wanted to just move in and kiss her. But I couldn't. I was frozen with fear. I was tense. I gripped the bottom of the chair. My palms were sweating. Only 6 inches between me and her. But I couldn't make it those last 6 inches. We eventually parted our separate ways that night. I trudged home alone to stay with my friend. I got up the next day, and I said, something needs to change. This can't be like this. I need to change this. I can't keep going on like this. This set me off on a journey over several years. I read books and articles. I talked to friends. I worked with a therapist. I even worked with a dating coach, which I would have been ashamed to admit as little as a year ago. But now I realize it was one of the most powerful and best experiences I've ever done. What did I learn through doing all this? Did I learn how to get a new haircut? Did I learn how to dress better? Did I learn to tell a joke? Did I learn to say a certain line? No, I learned to change the beliefs I had about myself. Because what was really holding me back? What was holding me back from those final 6 inches? It was really the feeling that I wasn't good enough. It was the feeling that I didn't really like myself all that much. And I didn't want to open up. I didn't want to be vulnerable. Because making a move would require me to be vulnerable and put myself out there. And I didn't really like myself, so I didn't really want to put myself out there. On the other hand, I might get rejected. I might make the move. She might reject me. And that would just confirm all the things I thought about myself. That would just confirm that, yeah, I'm really not that great. She thinks so too, so that means it's true, and I don't want to find that out. Over this process, I learned to change the beliefs about myself, to love myself, to accept myself, to change those negative expectations that I had. So instead of thinking, oh, I'm going to get rejected, change that up and think it's going to go really well. Because the only thing that I need to change is my beliefs. And that's what makes the impact. Now today, after changing my beliefs, I'm at such a different place than I was back then. I can walk up to a girl and I can say, Wendy, I think you're gorgeous. She paid me to say that, actually. we'll work it out afterwards. So I encourage all of you is to question all of your beliefs. Question every belief that you have. It doesn't matter if it's true. It doesn't matter if it's not true. All you can do is question is this belief helpful for me? Because the only thing that's stopping you from having what you want, from having the success you want, from having the happiness you want, is your own mind. And I can assure you that if you change your beliefs, you will change your life.